Ghostface is the masked killer from the horror franchise Scream. Ghostface first appeared in the film in 1996. The mask was a disguise used by local Woodsboro teens Billy Loomis and Stu Mocker that allowed them to go on a killing spree. The mask is used to conceal the identity of two different murderers, but seeing as how the costume is really common and is worn by people who aren't the killer, it's difficult to tell who the murderer is and who's simply wearing a costume. But what if Ghostface was a real killer in this day and age? That's the question we're asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. If this is your first time here, hit that subscribe and ask us a question in those comments. We at Life's Biggest Questions love topic suggestions from our subscribers, so if you would like to see a specific video on this channel, don't hesitate to ask us. And by the way, if you need a place to get your news on YouTube and you want to see more videos hosted by me, check out our sister channel, Inform Overload, for daily news updates you actually want to hear about. Ghostface is one of the most iconic mass murderers in the history of horror cinema. The plot twist was there was actually two killers instead of one, both using the mask to conceal their identity. But did you know that Scream was actually inspired by a true story? I thought it would be appropriate to tell you about it since we are discussing what would happen if Ghostface was real. In Gainesville, Florida, during August of 1990, someone was going around mutilating and murdering women. The first to die were Sonia Larson and Christine Powell, roommates. The next was Christina Hoyt. Then it was another pair of roommates, Tracy Pauls and Manny Taboada. All the victims were killed in their apartments. Christina Hoyt was found propped up on a bed and bent over at the waist, and whoever was responsible sliced off her nipples and placed her severed head on a shelf. All the victims were killed with a knife. Four of them were killed at the University of Florida. Whoever did it wanted to terrify anyone who found the bodies. The killer would place them in sexually provocative positions. While this was going on, a student at the U of Florida told the Associated Press that everyone slept with their knives nearby. At the time, there were no cell phones, no surveillance cameras, so it was that much harder to find the killer. Screenwriter Kevin Williamson turned on the television when he was house sitting, and he came across a special on the Gainesville murders. It scared him so much that he started fantasizing about a knife-wielding killer that was waiting for him outside the house he was watching. The Gainesville mutilations eventually inspired Williamson to write Scream, which was a huge success at the box office. The original film made $80 million initially and has now grossed well over $175 million. The Gainesville slasher turned out to be a man called Danny Rowling. He didn't wear a mask, but he was very disturbed. Rowling confessed to raping several of his victims, and he attempted to kill his own father in May of 1990. In total, Rowling killed 8 people, pled guilty to the murders, and was sentenced to death by lethal injection. He claimed his motive was to become a superstar, similar to the serial killer Ted Bundy. So first things first, if Ghostface was real and it really was two killers, they would have a lot harder of a time committing the murders in this day and age, and not getting caught early on. Scream was released in 1996. The Gainesville murders took place in 1990. This was way before the technological society we live in today. If there was any word about a killer on the loose on a campus, it would be all over social media. There would be trending hashtags and widespread panic. And remember how the Ghostface character would call landlines? Well, definitely not in 2018. Pretty much everyone has cell phones now. Does anyone still have landlines? And what about caller ID and voicemails? The victims in Scream didn't have to answer the phone. And by the way, have you ever noticed how long Drew Barrymore talks on the phone with the killer? Dude, hang up and call the cops. Yeah, there's no way that would happen in real life. Many households are also equipped with alarm systems and panic buttons. You hit one of those buttons if you're even a little worried, and the authorities are at your house within a couple of minutes. And these days, the Ghostface costume is not as common as it was in the 90s. Yes, it is one of the most popular costumes of all time, but it's somewhat dated in this day and age. If there really were mask killers running around wearing a Ghostface mask, there wouldn't be as many people wearing the costume, and the killer would be far easier to identify. There are surveillance cameras everywhere now, especially when it comes to university campuses, where the killer who inspired the Scream movie targeted most of his victims, and where the Scream movie took place. School shootings have resulted in campuses becoming a lot better about security. Whenever there's a security risk, people aren't running around attending parties like they are in the film Scream. Campuses are on lockdown, students barricade themselves into classrooms and dorm rooms, and campuses are even evacuated if there are potential threats. And let's not forget that Ghostface wielded a knife. Many Americans own guns in their households. Eventually, the protagonists in the film Scream do use a gun, but that happened at the very end of the movie. The first thing people would do if there really were a killer on the loose is get a gun and keep it on them at all times. Sure, a couple of guys running around in a mask might be able to kill a couple of victims, but a massacre wouldn't happen to the extent that it happened in Scream. Well, there you have it. These are just a few examples of what would happen if Ghostface was real. Did we miss anything? Let us know in those comments. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you like this video, you'll love the video that's clickable on the screen right now. And if you're a fan of this channel, make sure you leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so we can see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.